Let's all play What's My Line?
Well, hello, everybody. Welcome to another week. Donna, welcome back to the show. Alan, welcome back. Arlene,
thank you, Larry.
Welcome back.
You are welcome back and elegant as always.
Thank you, my dear.
How you doing?
Oh, fine, Larry, and you?
I'm okay. Well, I guess that's it. We'll see you next week, folks. No, we have two marvelous challenges for you today and a mystery guest who will baffle you. Right now with our first challenger, enter and sign in, please. Randy Mayer. Randy, you got your own age group up there today. Where are you from?
Wenatchee, Washington, the apple capital of the world.
All right, folks. Wenatchee, Washington, the apple capital of the world. Panel at 13 years old, Randy Mayer has been a circus performer for 5 years. He has a most interesting act, and we will now show the audience just what his act is. That applause was a little delayed because it's a little hard to read over his shirt. It was kind of interesting the way that worked out. Okay, panel, you're trying to find out just what Randy's act is, and let's start the questioning with Arlene Francis.
Thank you. Randy, are you in or on anything in your act?
Yes.
Are you in something?
No.
One down and nine to go, Soupy.
Randy, are there any animals involved in your act?
No.
Two down and eight to go. Donna.
Is there a lot of exercise involved in what you do?
How do you mean by a lot?
Like, I mean, what's like these? A lot of jumping around.
A lot of jumping around.
No.
Three down and seven to go. Alan.
Randy, would I laugh at your act?
No.
No?
Four down and six to go. Back to Arlene.
If you're not in anything, then you're on something, I take it, Randy.
Yes.
Are you on anything that has wheels?
That has wheels?
Yes.
Well, I'm afraid we're going to have to give you a sort of a qualified no.
No wheels. All right.
No, I didn't say
if
that.
If I find out it has a wheel, you'll be very upset.
Oh.
And you'll be sorry, too.
And you'll be sorry.
Oh, but I hear a trick.
I just said it was a qualified no.
Yeah.
Well, then you're going to let me stay on.
No, but we'll be back to you in a minute.
I think somebody will get it before you get back to me.
Soupy?
Are there any ropes involved in your act?
Ropes? How do you mean, Soup? Like something?
No, they hang him every night. Sure, ropes, like in a circus.
Ah,
like
I see what you mean. Six down and four to go. Donna?
Do you work high up in the air?
Yes.
What happens up in the air? Do you swing on those trapeze?
No.
Seven down and three to go, Alan.
Now, Larry gave a qualified note to Arlene's question about wheels, but that is there one wheel involved?
Yes.
There is one wheel involved, and it is involved. You're involved in it up in the air, right?
Yes.
Are you doing anything on a wheel on a wire, on a tight wire?
Yes.
Are you? You're not. Certainly, don't tell me you're doing that. You're not standing on top of a wheel on top of a tight wire.
Well, that's close enough for jazz. Yes, sir. He rides a unicycle on a high wire. Is what he does.
Buzzer celebrates match game misspellings in our own Buzzer Bee.
I said spaghetti and pizza.
The Match Game 3rd Annual Buzzer Bee starts today at 6, only on Buzzer.
I understand. It's all, as long as we've won the game.
They have won and we have lose, but we do have fun. Randy Mayer rides a unicycle on the high wire in the Wenatchee Youth Circus. What is the Wenatchee Youth Circus, Randy?
It's a non-profit organization formed from 85 to 90 kids from 5 to 19 or 18, whenever they graduate. And it's formed by not only a circus leader, but he's also principal of
of the high school?
Yeah, Orchard Junior
High. Now, where do you perform?
We perform in Texas, Arizona.
You travel around
travel
the country,
around
do you?
The country.
That's marvelous.
Everywhere.
We have some film of Randy on his unicycle on the high wire, and let's look at that now. Could we, Lloyd Gross? Would you roll the film so we can see him? There he is. Now, how high are you there?
30 feet.
You get scared up there?
Yeah, quite a bit.
Now, is that a net that you're working over?
Right.
Well, that's... Have you ever fallen?
Yes. I've fallen once on the unicycle and a couple times otherwise.
That pole really helps. Or is that just for look?
No, that's balance. For balance.
It really is for balance. Yes. That's marvelous, Randy. In addition to working on a unicycle on the high wire, Randy also performs on a slack wire. And he's going to demonstrate that for us right now. Randy, the stage is all yours. Lloyd, could you open the curtains, please? We've got a little slack wire set up there. And Randy has a unicycle. And he also has a marvelous bumper chute that he uses for balance on this.
Everyday work, exercise, and...
Enter and sign in, please. Lorraine Bachet. Where are you from, Miss Bachet?
Newport Beach, California.
Well, that's a very California color you have on
there. Thank you.
We wear that all the time. Okay, panel. Lorraine Bachet invented... this product, there it is. And we'll now show the audience what it is. And let's start the game with Soupy Sayers.
Thank you, Larry. Miss Bachet, this thing that you have invented, is it ever worn on a person's body?
Yes, it is.
Is it worn on a lady's body more than a man's body?
Probably you would think of it worn that way more, Soupy.
All right. Is it, when it's worn, is it ever worn around the waist of the person?
No.
One down and nine to go, Donna.
Is this, does it have something to do with slimming?
Not really. Two down, no. Eight to go, Alan.
You wear it around your head?
Yes.
Do you wear it to protect yourself from something? I mean, as in spilling makeup
only
on your hair?
Only in the broadest possible sense. Three down and seven to go, Arlene.
You wear it on your head, and does anything ever go over it rather than just by itself? Does it hold things in place on your... Has something happened to the... There.
Yes, it's going on and on.
Does it hold certain things in place on your head?
Well, it does, Arlene, but that's not its function.
You've given me a qualified no.
Yes.
Yes.
Soupy, would it have anything to do whatsoever with sleep?
No.
Five down and five to go, Donna.
Does it have anything to do with wrinkles?
Yes.
It somehow prevents wrinkles or stops them from developing or something.
Doesn't really stop them from developing, I don't think. Six down and four to go.
Turn it around. Let me see. Is that a point in front? Is that part in the front? Does that go in the forehead?
No.
No, I may have misled you, so you get an extra qualified no if you want one, Arlene.
Oh, no. Do you, but it does have something to do with the wrinkling of the skin, does it?
Yes.
Can you pull your skin up and hold it in place with this hat?
And what would you call the generic term for that?
Is there a generic term?
Yeah, for this kind of thing.
Facelift?
It is called an instant facelift, panel. Gorgeous. Lorraine Bashay is the inventor of Face Up, an instant facelift. Now, how does that work?
Well, it works basically on an isometric principle. Once you put it on and lift the muscles of a face just by talking, you're exercising against a resistance and thereby strengthening the muscles of a face.
Can you tell if somebody's wearing one of those?
Not always, no.
Do you have one on now?
Oh, yes.
You do?
Yes.
Where is it?
Under
it's underneath my hair.
Is it hard to put on?
No, no, it's very simple to put on.
Would you show us?
Yes, I'd love to. Biff?
Oh, my. Now, see here. Who is this now?
This is Biff Pinkley.
Biff?
Pinkley.
Biff Pinkley. Hi.
But
how do you
doesn't
do,
need any help.
Yes, I do.
Yes, I do.
Nevertheless, she's going to get some.
Well, sizing is very important, and Biff does wear a very small size. So would you hold this underneath your chin? See, the band comes in minimum of five different sizes.
The point goes in the back, then, doesn't it?
The point goes down and in the back, right. But we have head sizes up to 27 inches in circumference that we have to fit. And you relax. We go forward, and we turn it, lifting at the neck area. We touch at the eyebrow line, and we bring it back behind the hairline. See, it must be very comfortable. It's very subtle, the lift of the face. As you can see, it lifted from the jawline, took out the lines around the mouth, lifted the eyes. In some cases, it gives a Sophia Loren position to the eyes, and if you don't like that, you can bring the eyes down. They don't have to be up.
She looks terrific.
Yeah,
absolutely.
She looked terrific before.
A lot of help. Now we can cover it with a little band or something. You can hide it many ways.
Can you put a wig over it, I guess?
Oh, yes, surely. Wig or hairpiece.
Is it very tight? I mean, would it
No. The circumference of the band is the same circumference as your head. It must be comfortable or women wouldn't wear it.
Isn't that extraordinary?
Thank you, Biff.
Thank you very much. That's really terrific. Now, I am assuming, because it is my nature to do that, to make assumptions, that that's worn only by women. Is that
correct? No. I have sold to many men. But men wear it around the house as an exerciser, or with the advent of hairpieces for men, they wear it underneath a hairpiece.
You mean you put that on your head and you just go ahead about your business and suddenly you are exercised?
Well, yes, but you must understand, men improve with age.
I had always heard that. So does liquor. Soupy said, so does liquor.
They get a few lines in the forehead, perhaps, and underneath the eyes. But other than that, they look just great as they get older.
Really? And this can work on a man? What is that little piece there?
Well, this is for, in the Orient, I found that women usually have not a curve to the back of the head. So this is to release. This is a piece of Velcro that actually adheres to the hair at the base of the neck.
So
that it wouldn't slip, because logically you can't put a round surface on a flat head.
That's fascinating. What does it do for a man? The same thing it does for a woman?
Same thing it does for a woman.
I'll put it. You want me to put it on?
Yeah.
All right.
Try it.
Where do I sit? Here or there?
You can sit right where you are.
All right. What do I do?
Don't hurt him.
No. I'm liking this part the best so far.
Right. Would you hold it underneath your chin, please?
Yeah.
We take it up over the head. Around the neck.
That looks terrific.
How's it so far?
Now relax. See, we lift it.
Don't lie to me, Soupy. Do I look like Sophia Loren?
Yeah. You look a little like Charlie Chan.
Yeah.
You look like... Yeah, you look something like Bob Crane that way.
Yeah. I don't know. Would you take me out? Listen, that's really fascinating.
Well, look. It does work. I'm wearing one.
I think you better go over there and get it off of him. Thank you, Loren. Let me finish up. What's my... Are your panels all in place?
Our
blindfolds?
Wait, how about our masks?
All right, are your blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, sir.
Okay, would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Oh, Okay, panel, as you know, it's one question at a time. You have 2 minutes to find the identity of our mystery guest, and we'll start with Alan Ludden.
Well, that was instant recognition, I must say. Whoever you are, you walked in and they knew it. Are you, would I know you from television?
We?
Arlene?
From, a regular show on television?
Maintenant?
Now?
Yes? Is that you? That was a question, I think.
Question?
Oh, question.
Question, s'il vous plaît.
Are you in a regular comedy series playing now?
No.
Soupy?
Is this more than one question time?
No. We're just trying to get that one question right in several languages. It's hard to do.
Oh. I don't even know what was said. These short naps are great. Okay, now...
known from television, not part of a comedy show now.
But your fame came from a television show.
Mais oui.
Donna?
Oh, I know.
I sure. know it is. For the first time in my life, I'm going to get this one. It's Joanne.
No, I'm used to French.
Yes, Joanne. It is Joanne Worley. You are right.
I got it.
Do you have it too, Alan?
Yeah.
Did you have it too, Alan?
Yes.
Arlene, did you have it?
When she was talking to Arlene.
We have a lot of time to kill. Now, I thought I was being so French.
You were. You're about as good at disguising your voice as I am. You're the worst disguiser voice I ever heard.
Oh, I just came from Montreal where they were doing tons of French, and I was speaking and convincing them, and I thought I was being very good.
You were, Joanne. The problem was you sounded like a French Joanne Moore.
Oh, poor baby. Now we've all this time to kill. Let's play another game, okay?
What were you doing up there?
Le television show. See? You didn't recognize that part, didn't you? Yes, Al Hamill's comedy bag. It's like a little laughing, exactly.
Now, you're doing all guest appearances now, are you not?
Oh, oui. Mucho grande.
She does Password with great regularity.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
And you also have a nightclub act now, don't you?
Oui, oui. Oui. Of all the doesn't things... everybody?
No, everybody doesn't. Isn't everybody
Ed
in the world?
Ed McMahon does.
Who, Ed does?
Yeah. Ed McMahon.
Well, that's just
gave
Ed
up his finger for it, as a matter of fact.
And Soupy does.
Oh,
but I mean,
course.
Everybody doesn't. Which of the things that you do you like the most? Like nightclub?
No! What do you mean, darling? Oh, show business.
Yes.
Well.
How's Roger?
My potato pancake? Oh, he's marvelous. Just fine. He didn't come to New York with me this time because I had to go via Montreal. But I've been seeing lots of shows and things.
I didn't mean to distract you, Larry. I'm sorry. I just thought I'd... When she was kissing you, I just thought I'd throw in Roger.
Make him jealous.
Yeah, I really appreciated that. That was a big help.
Yes. Look, I was Betty White.
Who's she?
You know, the one who runs around with her mother all the time while you're working?
She's marvelous.
Yes, good.
I just wondered if anybody needed me anymore, because you guys were doing great. Listen, Pussycat, what are you going to do next? Do you know?
I'm going back home to take care of my stuff, and then I'm doing a lot of Canada, and I'm going to Toronto.
Yeah.
To do George Kirby's.
That's very nice
show.
Up there in Toronto.
It's very cold up there in Toronto.
It's very cold here right now. You live in Los Angeles? Is that where you live?
You knew that. You're just doing your business, aren't you?
Yes, I am. I didn't know because you're all over the place.
Yes.
Now,
yes, I am.
You're here and you're there. Are you going to come back to the East soon?
I love New York. I love shopping here. I just wish I had more time to hang into your stores and things.
The stores here, I think, are generally better than they are in Los Angeles. That must be of great interest to people in Omaha.
But I think buy lots of pretty things here. That's my life, shopping. Well, any woman loves her shopping.
Listen, we're glad that you came and played with us.
I loved it.
Why don't you come back sometime and be on the panel? That would be terrific.
Oh, good.
Will you?
Yes.
Okay, terrific, Joanne. Thank you
Goodbye.
For being with us and come back.
In the last year, there were 3 victims of cybercrime every second.
When a criminal has your personal information, they can do all sorts of things in your name. Criminals can use ransomware, spyware, or malware to gain access to information like your name, your birthday, and even your Social Security number.
That's why Norton and LifeLock are now part of one company. Norton 360 with LifeLock provides an all-in-one membership for your cyber safety that gives you identity theft protection, device security, a VPN for online privacy, and more. And if you ever have an identity theft problem, we'll work to fix it with...
Okay? Goodbye, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow. Have fun.
That's My Line is a Bar Christian Bill Todman production. Miss Frances Downs by Bonya Teller. This is Chet Gould speaking. This program was recorded.